Gettysman. On my right, Luca Claerbout, France. And on my left, Scott Evans, Ireland. Scott Evans to serve, level, play.
Single semi-final time. Ireland Scott Evans against surprise packet so far in this tournament, Lucas Claerbout. Three rounds for Scott. Three easy wins en route to this semi-final. Didn't give away any more than 15 points in one match. And a good 21-12, 21-8 victory over six seed Marcel Reuter of Germany in the quarterfinal. Lucas Claerbout probably created the biggest upset of the men's singles so far by beating the Malaysian Ben Hung Kwan. Malaysian who beat Scott Evans in the first round of last week's Welch. A little bit out of sorts against the Frenchman. The Frenchman still had to go out and do the job and did it in three. 21-7 in the 21-17 in the decider. Smash initially. Taking the speed off the shuttle at the net for the winner. Scott claiming the shuttle hit the net. Lucas, not happy about that. Lucas looking for the shuttle to be changed. Scott happy. Chair umpire happy.
Oh.
play from the Irishman. In the end. Forcing the error. Claerbout. First real unforced error from Evans in the match. Change of pace from Scott at the end of that rally. A smash down the line. Takes him to the interval lead. 11-6. Again, Evans all over it at the net for the winner.
13-6.
This time,
13.
Lucas. Oh. Better rally from the Frenchman. Coming into the game now, Claerbout. Finding a rhythm. Well read all the way from Scott.
14,
control. Feature of Scott's play this week has been his control at the net. Oh. Wrong shot choice at that point. Ah, string gone. So 11-15. Good attacking opportunity. Evans taking it, smashing it down the backhand side. Rounds got well in control of that smash. Not so in this match so far. Claerbout creeping back into it, only trailing by two. Service error.
18-16. Yes.
positions in defence. Good rally. Yes. Turning defence into attack on the cross court smash for the winner. Taking the Irishman to game point at 20-16. Certainly a point that Lucas will feel it got away. Oh, on the line. Scott electing to leave it, just out of shot. Still three more game points. That's it, first game to Scott Evans, 21-17. Good start from the Frenchman. Evans got himself into a 13-6 lead. Lucas fought back, got one in one, trailing 17-16. But Evans steadied the ship, took the first game, 21-17. And in pole position now to advance to the final tomorrow. Scott been in one final here before, the Irish Open, beaten by Rajiv Yusuf in 2008, I think. Something that Scott really wants to do is win his home international and, of course, get his first international win, which has still eluded him. Is this to be the one? Is this to be the week? Second game underway. Referee just camera going down the back of the court asking some of the spectators not to use flash. point from Claerbout. Smash from Scott. He's had more smash errors in this match than he's had in his previous three. Of course, a lot more pressure on it. Better player. Yeah, just on the line. See that replay. Strong in defense. Lucas looking back at Scott as if to say that one was definitely out. Again. It's a good lead, 3-point lead for Lucas. 6-3. Better control at the net this time from Evans. Too long over the baseline. Not enough depth in the backhand clear from Lucas Claerbout. Easy winner for Evans. Winner at the net, and Scott stares his opponent out of it. Just in. Lucas on the attack throughout the rally. Evans resolute in defense. Break and play. Scott requesting the floor to be mopped. Meanwhile, on the adjoining court, you had a semi-final between Sebastian Schottler and Lucas Corvey of France. Schottler, first game 21-18, but it's the young Frenchman up in the second, 16-11. Oh yeah. Corvey, or Claerbout acknowledges the accuracy of the smash. Stick smash this time. Right down at the feet. Assistance paying off for Evans. It's the Irishman again who takes the interval lead. 11-9. Corvey got off to a good start in this second game, leading 7-3. That's Evans who has the interval lead and already that one set lead. Set all on the adjoining court in the second men's single semi-final. Let's see, can Evans take this in two? Oh, complete miss. Happens to this level of player. Oh, Lucas tumbling over, no chance for Evans. Little break and play. Mop her in. Power on the stick smash from Evans. 12. Unforced error from Lucas. 2-point lead for Evans. Not enough depth in the lift. Clairvaux frustrated. 12. Easy winner for Scott. For the first time in this game, the Irishman has a 3-point advantage. flash of blood to the head, I think, on that occasion from Scott. Clever flick from Lucas.
16-17.
All of a sudden, the Frenchman is right back in this game. Seeing the power across court, too much for the Frenchman to handle. Real show of emotion from Scott this week. 20, takes him to match point. That's it. Second time of asking, Scott Evans takes the match in two games. 21-18 in the second, and it's the Irishman who advances to his second Irish international final. Lucky for Lucas. Good tournament from him this week. Sure we'll see much more of the Frenchman. Right now it's Scott in the final. We'll be back shortly with an interview with Scott Evans, followed by the women's singles semi-final between Ireland's Chloe McGee and Beatrice Corrales of Spain.
Well played. First real show of emotion from you this week. A happy man?
Yeah, delighted.
Yum, yum, yum.
Yeah.
Finish off that banana.
Yeah, very happy. I don't feel like I played particularly well.
Yeah.
I was a little bit more nervous in the semi-final because I don't know this French player, and yeah, so tough. It was a really really tough game actually.
Yeah.
Had to really really work hard.
Mentally tough.
Mentally, you know, tough, yeah, as well. I also made a lot of bad errors at the front of the court and stuff. So I didn't really feel as comfortable as I did earlier. But you know what, I worked extremely hard, pushed it as much as I could, and I came through, and I'm delighted with that. Not playing my best badminton and still winning is fine with me.
Yeah, even the couple of smash errors that, you know, that didn't happen early in the match.
Yeah.
I think you only counted two in the last match.
Yeah.
A few more in this one,
yeah.
But you settled yourself.
Yeah.
I think you had Tom behind you helping you out. How, you know, was it a big advantage having Tom really there?
Yeah, it was great. I have a really good relationship with Tom, and I've known him for a long, long time. The first time I trained with him was when I was 12 or 13. I went over to Sweden. He's a fantastic guy and a fantastic coach, and I have a lot of respect for him. So I'm quite happy he was here today, and then of course I had to ask him, and I'm very grateful that he says yes. So that was a huge help. A few tactics, and then of course the just the motivation from the back of the court is. It's great to have someone there, so I hope you can sit behind my court tomorrow for the final.
As I said, a lot of emotion in this one, a release of emotion in this match, much more so than we saw before, but a little incident when the shuttle hit the roof, it was in the first game. You were sure it would hit the roof. I don't think Lucas thought it hit the roof. Definitely hit the roof.
Yeah, well, sure, I was going back to hit it, and the shuttle touched the roof and dropped down a bit. So, and I knew the umpire didn't see it, so that's why I stopped the rally. So, if it didn't hit the roof, I would have played on, you know. I did the roof.
Still not quite sure who you're going to play. It's gone to three between Schottler and the young Frenchman, Lucas Corvey. I assume you met Sebastian before, but probably not Lucas.
Long time ago, Sebastian trained in Denmark when I was at the IBA. So that's a long time ago. But again, I don't really know either player, so I'm gonna, as soon as this is finished, I'm going over to have a look.
Right, Scott, listen, I'll let you go and have a quick peek at that. And many congratulations, and in your second Irish final tomorrow, best of luck.
Cheers.